you enjoyed the festivities of what? Hold on, hold on, hold on. We're not in church. I didn't just ask for $5. Are we enjoying Core Fest Day 2 or what? Yeah! So what the fuck is up? Are you motherfuckers ready for some more LSB shit? LSB! You know what I'm saying? You just seen my old ass and shit jumping around in a mosh pit. My doctor said I'm gonna die young. And I believe him. I super believe that motherfucker and shit. They told me not to do this dumb shit that I do. But I love this shit. I can't help it. So can we please get everybody towards the front? We're about to bring up some more LSP. And without you, it wouldn't be fucking right. Without you, it wouldn't be a motherfucking Core Fest. Without you, it wouldn't be fucking LSP. So bring your ass to the front of the motherfucking stage one time, please. Don't act like that. Denver, where the fuck you at? Yeah! And I don't care, hey, when I say Denver, it's because we're in Denver. You motherfuckers traveled from many, 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 many states. And I'm fucking grateful for that shit. I'm truly, truly thankful for every single one of you that made the trip, that called their job, that told them that you're puking, that you're pooping, that you got the fever, that you got fucking down curable. Whatever the fuck you told your job, whatever the fuck you told your relatives, whatever the fuck you told the fucking probation officer, but you're here. Thank you from the bottom of my motherfucking damaged, drunken, deranged, deformed, disturbed, and demented heart. Thank you. So without further ado, can we put some motherfucking L's up one time? And we're gonna bring out our brother, JP the motherfucking Hustler, featuring almost the entire GRE camp and shit. And we're gonna fucking do this shit right. Let's fucking enjoy day two of Core Fest. Fuck 2020, fuck COVID, we're back in this bitch. LSP!
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 Let's do this shit.
I go by the name Mr. Doja, AKA Dodo with that Flodo, AKA the Silverback Gorilla Pimp. We're in Denver right now, Core Fest 15. You know what I'm saying? Going on stage in a couple of hours. From Linwood, California originally, started rapping back in 89 with my brother Bandit, rest in peace. After he passed away, I kind of gave up on it, got back in the game, 07. Didn't work out, you know, shit happens. 2019, got with the Easley Branch. Met up with Killer Gabe via IG, he told me he was liking my shit. We kind of had that conversation. He schooled me to GRE. Did a collab, ended up meeting JP, did a collab, All I Need Is, and I fell in love with the label, they fell in love with me, and the rest is history. Again, started back in the late 80s, early 90s, my brother Bandit, he was a DJ at the time when I first started rapping, and then he started rapping and I followed suit. He's the reason why I even do music right now. I dedicate everything I do to the memory of my brother. But, you know, with the times and things was going on at the time, everything was major labels, and it didn't work for everybody. Now everything is independent labels, so being with an indie label, as strong as GRE, is the shit, so I'm about to blow up, that's all it is to it. Well, recently just dropped Pendulum with my boy, Spec One. We got another song coming out shortly, hopefully shortly. Got a collab coming with Killer Gabe. I got a collab coming with Evan the Evolve out of Australia. Just working, man. I was like, it's a whole lot going on. It's a whole lot to be happy about. Yeah, so I dropped a single Pressure with my girl J-Jig Cicero from the land, Cleveland. Shout out to J-Jig. I dropped Set It Off with my boy MCS Beats doing the hook, and he produced the song. Shout out to Joe T, the producer. He produced a lot of stuff that got coming up lately. Last album that I did was actually my first official studio album. It was called OMG, short for On My Grind. It's My Time on the Easley Branch label. I got got a good little buzz with the songs All the Smoke. I got a good little buzz with the title track on My Grind. So, you know, it's available everywhere, just like everything. The new album is going to be called The Book of Doja, Chapter 1. Just with everything that went on in the past couple of years in the history of my career as a MC, this kind of just leads up to where I am now and from where I came from, you know, just a progression. Check out the Pendulum Swing video on YouTube, on GRE YouTube channel with my boy Spec One. Shout out to GRE, LSP, everybody there, JP the Hustler, of course, being the man that he is and giving your boy an opportunity to shine. Shout out to Killer Gabe. Insane Poetry just told me that he want to work with me, so you know that's a blessing right there. So yeah, it's big things coming from your boy, man. It's big things coming. Y'all just get ready. We in Denver, man. I ain't never been here before. I'm trying to learn how to breathe out this bitch. Gore Fest 15, man. It wasn't one last year. I'm blessed to be on the one that we got this year. Happy to be here, man. And we gonna show our ass on stage later on.
What the fuck is up, Gore Fest? Yo, yo, yo. Can I get an LSP? Track with this man right here, the legend Insane Poetry, at the end of the set, so y'all rock with me for the whole thing. This is my dude Spec One, OG GRE member right here for a long time. It's been a minute since he performed, so show him some love and we're gonna rock this for y'all. Go ahead and kick that shit.
GRE.
Yeah.
Spec One, we are in Denver, Colorado at Gore Fest 15, I believe, 2021, and we are here to rock the fucking mic, you know, like we've been known to do. So, fuck, I've always been freestyling as long as I can fucking, you know, puberty pretty much, since like when people started getting into that kind of shit. But like, I want to say like 2004, 2005, I started recording music just with a little shitty ass computer mic. And I just gradually moved onward and upward, discovered a passion, and just discovered that I wanted to pursue this hardcore. I've been with a couple labels. I found my permanent home with GRE, Grim Reality Entertainment, for all your hip hop needs. But yeah, that's pretty much just me. I've just always been doing hip hop. I vary from West Coast hip hop to boom bap tracks to fuck horrorcore, of course. I love horrorcore. You know, you may even catch me rocking a mask from here, you know, from here and there. I do whatever the beat like demands. If I'm feeling that beat, I'm gonna do that beat. I don't care if it's a disco fucking track. Yeah, actually, that's when I first started was I used to sing for a punk rock band a long time ago, and we used to do covers of like D.I. and like, you know, like we covered Richard Hung Himself, for those of you who know what that is. I actually got to do quite a few shows back in the day at the Showcase Theater in Corona. R.I.P. Showcase. But yeah, and then, you know, man, I'll just be flat out with you. You know, there's too many egos in one band, so I just started doing rap. I've always freestyled when I got drunk, you know, when I was at parties and shit, you know, punk rock or not. And I found my home with hip hop. GRE, all right, a long time ago, I was doing some shows underneath another label, and I met up with these guys that were booking, and they were working with Grim Reality Entertainment at the time. And so a lot of people don't like the politics with, you know, throwing shows and having to do ticket sales or whatever. I found it with GRE, it was really easy to make a lot of money on your own shit if you hustle and you do your own shit and you're serious about your craft. And so there was something that I liked there, of course. And so I pursued that. And then when the new breed era started coming, I was definitely, for sure, I made sure to get on that train before I left the station. You know, we've been chugging along ever since. About 6 or 7 years ago, I had a child. Certain situations presented themselves with that required me to take a hiatus. So I've been off for a while, you know, doing my thing, you know, as a man and shit for my family. But I'm back. I know a couple of you ain't gonna like that. I know that one dislike on my music video. I know who you are, and I had the person share it on Facebook so you'd see it. Yeah. So, but yeah, I'm back. It is what it is. You know, I'm back. I'm harder than ever. I'm coming harder than ever. I don't know what it is. Any artist that's in the game will tell you that sometimes you have your droughts with music, and sometimes you have your floods of music. Well, right now I'm sinking. I'm drowning in lyrics right now. So, you know, any artists that want to get at me on a collab, hit me up, but just do me a favor, make sure you write that. It's got to be a collaboration. I don't want to finish your track for you because you could write another 16, please. But I'm back. I'm doing my thing. I ain't going to stop. I really got to say a lot of love to JP, the Hustler, for never giving up on somebody, even though he probably should have at times. But I really appreciate it, and Grim Reality is definitely my home for life. We got a music video that just came out with a single called Pendulum Swing, featuring me and my homeboy, Mr. Doja, Dodo with that Floto. We just dropped that. It's on YouTube. Definitely check that out. Leave it a like, leave it a dislike if you're one of those guys. It's all good by me. Before that, we dropped the Nothing to Prove remix by Lupa Fame. I didn't know how he could have made a track that I already liked a lot better, but he did that by an abundant amount. So mad love to Lupa. He's a fucking genius when it comes to production. Him and JP are my favorites. I got that out. More to come. I got an album that I'm working on right now. I'm not really letting anybody know about the name or the album artwork yet, but when me and the label decide we're gonna do that, we'll let you know. But there will be singles coming off that definitely soon. Shout out to Scum and LSP for having us out this year, for letting GRE rock a set. Shout out to JP for making that happen on his end. Shout out to Mr. Doja for doing the video with me. House of Dismemberment for all your mask making needs. This dude's really cool. He hooked me up, took care of me. Just shout out to everybody out there that's actually doing it. That's not talking about it, but actually doing it.
I'm still here, still doing my thing. Still bringing you everything that I have come to bring. Pendulum swing, I let the pendulum swing. Swinging back and forth, I use the mic as a pivot. Get this beat about the business, and the static to the wind. It's been a better pivot game. Put respect on Doja A. Me and Spectre make this thing. We a problem, we ain't playing. You don't want to win the vote, but look what I can really do. All that crap can be the scrap. If you want to pick a deal, now you need a new reel. Epidemic.
My name is Unknown Caprice. I'm at Denver, Colorado right now. I'm at Gorefest. This is day 3. Day 1 was fire. I just came out to kick it, have a good time. And this is my first time at Gorefest. So it's been a real time. Day 2 was really dope. I did my first show for Gorefest, did my solo, and also rocked with the whole GRE crew, which that was really fun. Today is day 3, Sunday. And yeah, like Scum says, we're in that zombie moment right now. So it's all love. Man, just being a love for the art form of music, period. Believe it or not, my first show was a Prince concert. And just seeing him perform made me feel like, hey, I think I kind of want to do something like that. And later, I started seeing show after show, different artists, from LL Cool J to Slick Rick, NWA. Later throughout, I ended up hooking up just by freestyling in the bathroom with all the homeboys and stuff. And pretty much just the love of it. Love of it got me in this game. First time I hit a real studio was like 1998. And That was with my cousin. We put a group together called Two Trill, and we got together, pieced our money up, found a real studio, Creation Lab, School of Audio. As one of the engineers that engineered our first project, and we just went in there and started having fun with it. First project was called What You Bring to the Table, and like that first year, first 2 years, we sold like probably like 1,000 out of the trunk. It's kind of like E40. We had the backpack full of CDs. We didn't have social media at that time, so we just basically stood on the corner and asked people. You know, we didn't have Facebook. We didn't have anything like that. All we had was us getting on the street, networking, handshakes and hugs. And that's kind of how it went. That's how it started off. Yeah, COVID hit. Once COVID hit, it didn't stop me. I just continued to keep pushing, keep going forward. I didn't let that slow me down. It didn't cage me in. I ended up dropping several singles. I dropped one called Every Single Day. I dropped that one. Yeah, when I perform my Fuck 'Em song, I get a cool response with that because everyone can truly relate to throwing the middle finger up, you know what I'm saying? So it's basically about just throwing the middle finger up to whatever is trying to distract you from what you're trying to do and how you're trying to move forward in life. Basically trying to slow you down, dead weight, you know? So you gotta drop the dead weight so you can rise higher, kind of like one of those old hot air balloons. You know, you just drop those sandbags off so you can rise. So Fuck 'Em was basically about that. My thank you song I performed, that's a special song to me because my 15-year-old son made the beat and he was like, Dad, I want you to rock to this style of beat. So I took that time out during COVID, wrote to it, wrote three verses, and they challenged me again. My son challenged me again. Was like, Dad, you should go ahead and do one more verse on that one. So I went ahead and dropped the fourth verse. And Thank You is all about, you know, my haters and my lovers. So that's basically what Thank You is about, just kind of giving a shout out. Yeah. To my Fireball.
Yeah, welcome to my Fireball.
Hey, that's a great song. We did a music video for that a couple years ago, and it's basically set on like a house party environment. A costume party. It was designed for all good people to come together, dress up, put some mask on, paint on your face, have a good time, and through that, Fireball was created. But for some reason, when I'm performing, I end up seeing a lot of Fireball shots coming, and that really wasn't what it was about. But for some reason, Fireball shots appear, so.
Nice.
I guess that's a good thing. Yeah, Studio Get though, that was a cool experience. I met them, I believe, a couple years ago. I guess it was I don't remember which tour it was, but GRE was in the house and Saint Poetry was there. My brother D-Rock was in the house. And then that's when I met Studio Get though, and I just so happened to be performing at this show. And a lot of good things came out of that. And as we progressed and moved forward, show after show, Studio Ghetto kind of got at me and they hit me up and they respected what I was doing. And they just said, man, brother, we just want to help you. We want to be a part of whatever you're doing. We're not trying to take nothing away from you. And they asked me to sign with them. I thought it over, looked at all my options, and went with it. And that was basically like my second label that I was a part of. And I just went with it, and I rocked with them for 2 years, kept the loyalty up. And now I'm a part of GRE. I believe GRE seen the same thing in me. And it's just the next level up, and we're just moving forward, continue to keep pushing this music. We did a new single called Explosion, featuring my brother JP. Featuring my brother JP, man, and it was a great experience. He came up, which was special to me. He came up all the way from Texas and shot the video. We tried to start earlier. We really didn't want the rain, but rain ended up happening, and through that we created a good video. Actually, it's coming out real soon. I think maybe in a week or two it should be dropping. It's called Explosion. It's basically the scene is set on classy and rough at the same time. You know, it's basically, we're class act type of people, but at the same time, we're gonna shoot it by old car. We're gonna shoot it in the laundry room. But I don't have a Lamborghini, so I'm not trying to, you know, bring that to the table. But when I do have it, we'll shoot with that too. It's all love. I want to shout out to the damn haters, man. I thank y'all, man. I thank y'all for not believing in me. I thank y'all for not wanting to listen to my music. I thank y'all for quitting and giving up. I thank y'all for just talking. I thank y'all for talking, because with y'all talking, it made me put action to y'all's talking. So with that said, it helped me grow. And in the process, I got love for you too. I still want you to keep pushing like I'm pushing, and just keep on moving, man. That's how Unknown does it, so it's all good. I like to say check, check. And to all my unknowns, shout out to my homegirl, my lady, Kerosene. She believes in me. Whenever I doubt myself, because I'm hard on myself, whenever I doubt myself, she pushes me up, continues to tell me to continue doing what I do. And once I hit the stage, everything just becomes very clear to me that this is what I should be doing, this is what I should continue to do. I love the people, I love handshakes and hugs, I love just being honest and open with people and speaking from my heart and being as real as I can be.
We're gonna keep this rock and roll.
Why don't you just
hustle and grind shit?
What up, man? It's D-Rock from the White Noise, Grim Reality Entertainment. We're right here, right now, Gore Fest 2021, third day, Sunday. We all had a great time. It's been going down. We're working on multiple collabs with Beast Mode Warriors, Cooley Booley, D-Gaff, Johnny Richter, and many, many more that we have holding down right now. Next show, we got Chucky Chuck, September 25th, Houston, Texas, BFE Rock Club. We got White Noise, Riffic, I-10 Slim, EK Rowdy, and a couple others. Okay, this year in 2021, we're gonna be probably hitting up Madness and Mayhem, and we're gonna be rocking out with Unknown Caprice, Scum, Insane Poetry, September 24th. Nero's gonna hook us up. We're gonna come out there and rock a show for you guys. So I forgot to add that one. And it's gonna be going down. We got so many people from LSP, GRE in the building. It's gonna be a huge show, so y'all cannot miss that out. It's gonna be Madness and Mayhem, 24th through the 26th, I believe. We did, what was that, Underground United 2017?
Mm-hmm.
2017, and then we did Mindo Dope, Dope Noise Tour 2018. It was White Noise and Mindo Dope from California. We did like 15 stops on each one of these tours. They were awesome, and we met a lot of people, dropped a couple of songs with each one of these artists that we toured with. And on top of that, we met with Mindo Dope, met a lot of growers, and people that influenced us to make this music to begin with. Cool. So like Potluck, Cottonmouth Kings, all those we've been really close with in the last couple of years, and working and doing music with these guys that we all grew up with and listened to. We have two or three videos out right now that are solid. We're working on more right now, but the first one we shot is called Godzilla. We did it in downtown Denver with Paperboy, AKA Cody Jones. Shouts out to Cody Jones, Paperboy. Thank you for helping us shoot that. And the next video we have, we shot in Houston, Texas, and it's called In It's Winning. So you guys gotta check that one out. That one's our latest, kind of latest one. But then we have a new one, and it's featuring Bone Stuff from Max Murder Boys, and it's called This Is God. And my brother B-Dub made the animated video. It's not a really official video for it yet. We're waiting on Bone Stuff, and we're gonna make an official video for it. But it's pretty dope, so you guys gotta check out these three videos that we got up right now. And we are also working on a video and a new collab with Beast Mode Warriors, and this is about to happen right now. Shout out to B-Dub, shout out to Jacoby Dog, shout out to JP the Hustler, shout out to Unknown Caprice, shout out to my wifey, shout out to everybody that's supporting us from day one, shout out to Jaeger, it's our neighbor one right there. But shout out to all you guys for really supporting us, coming to all the shows, buying tickets, buying merch. We have new merch out. If you haven't noticed, we got the White Noise GRE collab. We got it in Astros colors representing the H-Town. That's where we're holding it down. Houston, Texas, where we're from. That's where we're going to rip. And that's where we're from right now. But right now we're Denver, Colorado, doing it big at Gore Fest Day 3. And I want all you guys, check us out on Spotify, Reverb, anything that you got, YouTube, wherever, anything you can get, we got it. We're on it.
Tim Torment from Funny Farm Records. I reside in Dallas, Texas, and we are in Denver, Colorado, a city that I love, for Gore Fest 15, which is the second Gore Fest that I performed at. The first solo set I've done, and just the second set that I've done, period. The first time was with Nairo the Madman, and it was a split set. I got started in 2013, really got serious writing raps, had my first show by 2014. I've been working behind the scenes since probably 2005, selling tickets for people and whatnot, just working behind the scenes. Something drove me to actually get in front of the mic around 2013, 2014. And I've got two official albums out with Funny Farm Records, a bunch of miscellaneous shit going down on SoundCloud and whatnot from back in the day. I've got two singles that I am about to release in the near future, and a new album built that I am having mastered and cleaned up and ready for release, hopefully by spring. I dropped the Fade to Black video, but it wasn't super recently. It was more like March, February, I think, around the time the Insane Poetry Run dropped. We dropped that video. The album is the Splenetic Era.
Okay.
And then I have two singles that I'm not willing to really talk about right now.
Okay.
That I'm going to drop very soon. Before the next album. The first tour I ever got on was back in 2014, 2015, I believe. It was the worst tour I've ever done. I'm just gonna jump to this year.
Okay.
Because I've done so many tours. I've gotten the pleasure to go on the road with Insane Poetry, which we actually had to cancel halfway through and start the second week later due to snowmageddon or icemageddon, depending on what part of the country you live in. And then I got to go on the road with the Beast Mode Warriors, who is JP the Hustler and Slice the Wicked, which was amazing and very insightful. And then most recently, I got to go on the road with Scum, also an LSP artist. And it was the longest run that I've ever done. And I got to fill a couple slots in, even though that I was playing a backseat position. I was driving, handling roadie type shit, stuff like that. And then the next one that we're supposed to do is the Funny Farm Records tour, coming up after Madness and Mayhem in 2 weeks. I mostly like to do my own thing. I record music for me, kind of do it on my own terms. I would like to make a living with it, but you know, not like a super rich, famous type living. I like working behind the scenes a lot, driving, doing roadie stuff, merch stuff, just hanging out behind the scenes. I just love being wrapped in the music life, man, and I just love doing that type of stuff. So honestly, I don't care if it's on the stage or off the stage. I would just like to be wrapped in the music life, doing what I love, making some kind of income back from it. I'd like to say thank you for anybody who's given me a chance on the road with them. LSP for sure, Funny Farm Records, Nairo the Madman, Insane Poetry, JP the Hustler, Scum. Just everybody who has given me a chance to kind of show them who I am out on the road. And I'm not really about shoving my stuff, my personal artist stuff down people's throat. I just like to be wrapped in the music life and do what I do. And that's just it, man. I love everybody who shows me love in this game.
Let's rock this shit. Let's get them.